Let's make some Apple Intelligence shortcuts. I've remade some of my most popular automations with the new iOS 26 Apple Intelligence Actions, like quickly pulling a recipe from Instagram, getting key points and summaries from photos of book pages. I've upgraded my Ultimate Movie shortcut where you can search where to stream a movie and save it to Apple Notes, and added some new features to ones like a high temp and time of day alert. Now, links to all these shortcuts are down in the description. You do need to be running iOS 26 either on your iPhone, iPad, or Mac, and have Apple Intelligence on that device. Run betas at your own risk. You can wait till the fall. All these shortcuts will work then as well. But I just couldn't resist because this new action is that good. Let's jump into shortcuts and let me show you the action I'm talking about. This is one of the shortcuts you could download below, and it's actually a way to test the different models directly from Apple Intelligence. The new action that's available is under the Apple Intelligence section, and it's called Use Model. And what's really powerful is you can use Apple's Private Cloud Compute, the on-device LLM, so even if you're offline, the shortcut will work, and you can still use ChatGPT. But if you've used ChatGPT shortcuts actions before, you know they're buggy, you have to have opened the app recently, and that is not the case with this action. If you want to use ChatGPT in shortcuts, but have it work consistently, using the Use Model action and this extension works great. Now this shortcut is actually one I'll use in some of the other shortcuts, and what this does is I actually run the same prompt through all three models. So it uses the cloud model for Apple Intelligence, the on-device model, and ChatGPT, and then formats all three responses so I can see how the models compare. And one other detail, I have found the on-device model just errors out if you give it too much content, so I typically default to the cloud model. But let's start with a shortcut that adds a feature Android has had for a while. I call this Circle to Search. Now you can use Visual Intelligence and then Google Reverse Image Search or ChatGPT, but here you can actually see what Apple Intelligence will give you from an image. So when you run this shortcut, you'll start by taking a picture. I'll take a picture of this book here. Then when I tap Use Photo, it'll bring up the markup commands. And I'm actually going to search the object that I want Apple Intelligence to focus on because the prompt tells it to pay attention to what's in the red circle. Then when I confirm those changes, it's going to send it to Private Cloud Compute, Apple Intelligence model, and then it'll give me a response. And it accurately tells me about the book. Of course, the title and author were in the image, but the summary is accurate as well. Now, Apple Intelligence models don't seem to have very recent data. 2023 seems to be the latest it's been trained on, and it also can't search the web, so it will be limited when compared to Google Image and ChatGPT, but nice that you can see what Apple Intelligence will do with a parsed image. Next, this was a popular shortcut, and now it works even better with Apple Intelligence. You can run this from the share sheet, and when you're looking at a reel or maybe a TikTok, and there's a recipe in the caption, this is going to get the raw HTML of that social post, and then Apple Intelligence action can actually parse that out and create a note with that recipe information. So I'm actually going to run this from Instagram. And let's say I'm looking at a recipe here. It could be a reel or a static post. I'm going to tap the share button with that envelope, hit the share button here, and now I can run my shortcut. I'll use the reel recipe to note AI. And then when I run that, it's going to find the content of the recipe. And one of the great things about Apple Intelligence actions is it's actually really fast. I have found this faster than ChatGPT, and I ran all that in real time. And then it created an Apple note with the title of the recipe. It has the ingredients here and the steps. I also like how Apple Intelligence formats this stuff as opposed to ChatGPT. This shortcut also includes a link to the reel or post down at the bottom. I'll also include a second shortcut for the reel recipe, and that's called the Reel Recipe Model Comparison. This uses that first shortcut that I showed you to run the same prompt through all three models, and you can see how those responses compare. And here, the output you'll see, the cloud model gives you this response. You can see what the on-device model would give you here, and even what ChatGPT would give you at the bottom. You can see which you like the best, and if the on-device model works well enough for this use case, that's gonna mean it doesn't have to connect to the internet, you can use it offline, but it's also gonna be faster than any of the cloud or ChatGPT models. Next, I call this my Apple Newsroom summary, but you can do this with any RSS feed. Put the RSS feed in the top action, choose how many items you wanna summarize, and then it's gonna summarize as many articles as you wanted, and this time it's going to use Apple Intelligence instead of ChatGPT. Now there actually is a built-in strictly summarize action. If you go to Apple Intelligence, scroll down, you'll see summarize text is an action you can use, but you can't really customize it. You can tap summarize and choose create key points or just generally summarize, but I like adding a prompt like I would with ChatGPT. And so that's what I have there. Then when I run this, it's gonna get the last three articles from the Apple Newsroom RSS feed. It's going to summarize each of those articles and then put them together in a single output. And now we have one paragraph summaries of the latest three articles from the Newsroom RSS And because you have that custom prompt, you can tell it, give me a shorter summary, keep it to a maximum of 3 sentences, and that's the power of these new actions versus just a generic summarize action. Next, I'll include a link to this brainstorm shortcut, which basically lets you talk to your phone for a while, it'll dictate that text, and now it's going to use Apple Intelligence to create an Apple Note with a summary and key points of everything you said. I won't take the time to run it right now, I've shown this in past videos, but you can download and use it with the link below. Next, one of my favorite shortcuts is my Book Points AI. I like reading physical books, but you can't really highlight or bookmark pages digitally, so I take photos of pages that have quotes or key points I want to remember. So what this shortcut does is lets you choose photos, you can select multiple, it gets the text from those images, that's a built-in action, and then uses Apple Intelligence to summarize and pull key points, and then puts it all together. So when I run this shortcut, here are pages of a book I recently read, Creativity by John Cleese, and now it'll go through all those images, pull the text, have Apple Intelligence summarize and make key points, and there's the Apple Note, it titles it the name of the book, I put that in there manually, here's the key takeaways up at the top, and any interesting or fun pull quotes down at the bottom. Next, I have one that will summarize an email and pull any events based on a PDF, but I'm also going to include my straight PDF summary. With this shortcut, whenever you're viewing a PDF, you can activate the share sheet. It will send this to Apple Intelligence and provide a summary based on the content. For this one, I'm actually using the on-device model, which is pretty good at summarizing, and this way you can use it offline. Here's actually a PDF of Apple v. Epic's contempt order, so I can just tap and hold, hit the share button, and when I run my PDF summary shortcut, now it provides a short summary, and that's actually a really long PDF, and it even pulls out some key points, and that's the Apple Intelligence local on-device model. So now you can summarize any PDF right here on your phone locally. Next, I recently made a shortcut that actually pulls schedules from different teams, sports teams, and then shows you when the next game is scheduled. Well, I used ChatGPT the first time I created this shortcut, but now it's using Apple Intelligence to parse the HTML from those websites, and I find it actually works much faster and still gives me great results. And now I have 3 different teams, 3 different URLs, tells me when the next game is for each team, works great. Now, if you want to use this for one of your sports teams, just go into the shortcut and replace one of these URLs with the URL of your team's schedule. Typically, it's the name of the team or their website and the word schedule after the forward slash, and just make sure you add a new line. And you can add as many as you'd like. Just hit return, paste in another URL for your team schedule website, and then it will do all the schedules of the websites you have listed here. Next, I've had several people ask about the high temperature for today's forecast and the time it's going to happen. Now, I was struggling to do this with the built-in weather actions, so I've created this shortcut. I've not shown this in any previous video, but it's actually going to use the National Weather Service to get the forecast from your location, longitude and latitude, and I was having trouble parsing the data, but this is a great use case for Apple Intelligence because I can just give it a bunch of raw information, tell it how I want to format it, and then I can pull out just what I want. Namely, the time that the high temperature will be for that day, and create an alarm for that. And then it also shows a notification with that information. So when I run this shortcut, I can tap allow. It's going to find the high temperature for the day based on the National Weather Service API. It created an alarm when that high temperature is happening, even labels it high temp, you see there at the bottom. And it's going to show me a notification letting me know when the high temperature is for that day and what it's going to be, 92 degrees. All right, this next one I'm really happy about. I have a massive movie shortcut, which lets you search for a movie, it parses the Ultimate Movie database, and it has my API key in there, but it's free to use, and then it will parse where you can stream it, and previously I had to show a web view, use copy and paste actions, but now with Apple Intelligence, that's no longer the case. And while it shows using ChatGPT, this is actually that Apple Intelligence action, which is more reliable and fails way less. So now when you run this shortcut, you can search for a movie. Let's say Minecraft. It'll show you several options, including a synopsis of the movie, then choose which movie you mean. Obviously, I mean the 2025 one. Then it's gonna go and find where this movie can be streamed. That information is coming from the movie database as well. Then it's gonna parse all the places where you can stream it. So here you have HBO Max. And if there's a place that actually costs, it's going to include that information here in this large menu. I'm gonna choose Max. And then it's going to create a note with a link to watch it on Max, and it even includes the movie poster, creates this Apple Note nicely, all using Apple Intelligence. Our last two shortcuts, and these are some of my personal workflows when I'm making videos and podcasts. This is actually a prompt I use whenever I make a YouTube video. Typically, I give ChatGPT my transcript, and then it will parse a title and description and tags for that video. Now I'm going to use the run model test shortcut, so make sure you have this shortcut downloaded as well, but I can run this from the share sheet based on a transcription I have on my phone. So here I have a transcript from one of my videos. It's just a plain text file. I'm going to go ahead and hit the share button and then choose the YouTube details shortcut. Now it's going to take all that text, which I find some videos are a little too long and the local and even private cloud compute models will error out. So that's why I'm using ChatGPT. But we're going to see how the model comparison works with this video. And it happened pretty quickly. You'll see here's the Apple Intelligence private cloud compute option. It did not pay attention to the maximum tags that I told it. This is way over 500 characters. That was in the prompt. So the cloud one was okay. The on-device LLM was also okay. Did better with the tag limit and not bad for the title and description. And then at the bottom, you'll see the same prompt running through ChatGPT. I typically find when it comes to YouTube titles, descriptions, and tags, I still prefer what ChatGPT is giving me. And one of the things in the prompt was tell me what videos I mention at the end so I can put it on the end screen. ChatGPT is still the only one to tell me which videos I mention. Neither Apple Intelligence model gave me that information. So when it comes to my YouTube video information, I'm still gonna use ChatGPT, but run it through the Apple Intelligence action because it's more reliable. All right, and the last shortcut, if you're still here, kind of a special treat. This is the Primary Tech Daily shortcut that I use every day. If you didn't know, I host a podcast with Jason Aten every week called Primary Technology. Subscribe above in the link below. And if you support the show, you get our daily show. Well, for the daily show script, I basically have several websites where I pull their articles via RSS. I get to choose them from the menu that appears, and then Apple Intelligence is now going to summarize them. This way I can read the script and make the episode. Then it's going to add all that information to an Apple Note. So I'm going to run this shortcut. I'm going to choose Get New, and now I'll choose what articles I want to include. Then we'll create an Apple Note with an episode title and description. I'll usually massage those afterwards. Links that I'll put in the show notes to the articles, and then full summaries of each story. So you can download all those shortcuts in the video description below. Remember, you do need to be on the beta and have Apple Intelligence on your device. And before you go, if you want even more shortcuts content, I'd love for you to join the community at create.beard.fm. Here you can join over 1,500 people who are talking about shortcuts, sharing their own, asking for help. And if you support the community with $5 a month, you get access to my Shortcuts GPT, which has really been helpful with using APIs from websites, my shortcut of the week, and you'll see shortcuts there that I'd never share in my videos, plus access to my shortcuts database that's searchable and priority shortcuts request, and I reply to every one. That's create.beard.fm. Would love if you join there and you're supporting the channel when you become a member. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit that like button. Any questions or requests, leave them in the comments below. We'll still be doing shortcuts that are not Apple Intelligence. I have a bunch of requests already lined up, so drop them down in the comments, and I'll put two videos up here that I think you'll like if you're into shortcuts. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.